Marvin Gerard graduated magna cum laude from Harvard, where, at the tender age of 31, he was appointed the third youngest full professor in the institution's history. He served as a prosecutor for 3 years, state of New York, later joined his father-in-law's criminal defense firm as a full partner. He was on the short list for employment at the federal bench when his marriage to the boss's daughter hit the skids. Serves a year for attempting to kidnap their son. Gets disbarred. Currently, he's incarcerated for 7 to 10 in the Cumberland FCI. Although he's been disbarred, Gerard acts as shadow counsel to some of the biggest players in the criminal underworld. Politicians, CEOs, and one Raymond Reddington.
Marvin Gerard?
Who are you? What am I doing here?
I'm Special Agent Samar Navabi. You've been briefed?
Rousted out of bed, cavity searched, shackled, transported like livestock, yes. Briefed? No.
One of your former clients is holding 17 civilians hostage in that diner. He's demanded that we bring you here.
Which one?
Raymond Reddington.
I have nothing to do with this. I don't know what he wants from me. I am not going in there.
Well, you are going in.
This will never work. If he asks me, I'm gonna have to tell him that I'm wearing a wire. It would be unethical for me to lie to my client.
Lizzie, please, take a seat. I'll have Chewy bring you a piece of pie. I promise you'll thank me.
But you cut it out. A lawyer? How is that gonna help us with this?
Lawyers find and exploit loopholes. It's what makes them so loathsome. And Marvin Gerard is the most loathsome of them all. That's what makes him so invaluable. Speak of the devil.
Hello, Marvin.
My parole hearing is next week.
Christmas came early.
Think this is a gift? They'll probably tack on 5 more years just seeing you breathe in my direction.
Are you wired?
Of course I'm wired. I told them not to bother. I told you not to bother.
Elizabeth. Marvin Gerard.
Criminal attorney.
One down. Not necessarily in that order.
Finally, I am in the presence of greatness. You're the one. You're the one who made him throw away his freedom.
Good God, Marv, let it go.
What, you asked for my advice?
I was simply giving you, as a friend, a heads up regarding my plans. You were a wonderful attorney.
And you were a terrible client.
Two.
Not that you were innocent.
But, I just got engaged. Becky Weinberg.